time. Clear the mind, give myself a change of atmosphere. Very much, ladies and gentlemen, once again, a very, very good evening to you all. It's lovely to be with you in the Armagh City Hotel. I'm going to ask you all to please keep your hands clapping and welcome to the stage your hosts of tonight's show, Phil Mack and Lisa Stanley.
Hello, everyone.
Good evening, Armagh. It's nice to be back to see such a wonderful crowd. We hope you're going to have a fantastic evening in a fantastic hotel, in a fantastic intimate. Is that right?
That is right. Are we in good form?
Were any of you here last year? Was anyone out here last year?
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you, book your cabs late tonight because we've been having very late evenings. No one's been going home. The lads in the band have been going to bed at 7 in the morning. Is that right? Great band.
That's right.
Now, as we always say, and we're not joking, if you're with someone you shouldn't be with, don't stand in front of the cameras.
All right, stop.
And of course, tonight, the first time in Ireland, they just flew in about 3 hours ago. I know some of you were here when they were sound checking. Ben and Carmen Steniger.
Oh, Ben and Carmen.
Came upon an accident on a lonely county highway. He could hear a baby crying, see the folks as they lay dying, and the mother said with her final breath, "The baby has no kin, won't you please take him in, give him love and give him all your best." So he took him to the big house where he worked as a sharecropper. From that day on he never was alone. And when the little white boy cut his hands from picking berries, he came running, crying to Mr. Jones, "I'm in trouble, come get me, Mr. Jones. You're the only one to help me. In this world I'm so alone. Yes, I love you and I need you, Mr. Jones. I'm in trouble, come and get me, Mr. Jones." He grew up and got in trouble with the law and on the double. Soon his name was known throughout the land. He robbed a bank in Dallas, killed a man in Oklahoma. Each time he'd take a phone up in his hand. Each time the county sheriff stopped by, a part of Mr. Jones would die. And from his eye a tear began to run. And he'd begin to pray that he'd live to see the day. He'd hold the boy, he'd raise just like a son. "I'm in trouble, come and get me, Mr. Jones. You're the only one to help me. In this world I'm all alone. Yes, I love you and I need you, Mr. Jones. I'm in trouble, come and get me, Mr. Jones."
One Saturday night, as he lay in jail, from fighting and just raising hell, that Sunday morning, he picked up the phone. And as the telephone was ringing, back home in church, the choir was singing, "I'm going home for Mr. Jones." And when the choir stopped singing, well, the telephone, it just kept on ringing. as they slowly laid Mr. Jones to rest. There are those that say, well, Mr. Jones, he passed away from a broken heart and just plain unhappiness.
Oh, I'm in trouble, come and get me, Mr. Jones. You're the only one happy in this world, I'm all alone. Yes, I love you and I need you, Mr. Jones. I'm in trouble, come and get me, Mr. Jones.
Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones, please pick up the telephone. Mr. Jones, I need you, Mr. Jones. Sheriff, open up this jail. I want to go home.
Something must have happened to Mr. Jones.